Well, hi everyone. Well, today I wanted to do a quick follow-up to a video I made a couple of years ago that actually is one of my most popular videos. And it's on quick, easy, inexpensive tips for fertilizing tomatoes. Now, I don't really remember the exact name of it, but we will post a link at the end of this video. But I've had so many questions on specifics, such as how I make the fertilizer, how often I apply, that I thought I would do a quick little follow-up tonight because I do need to fertilize some of my tomatoes. So what I use to fertilize my tomatoes is basically fish fertilizer and Epsom salt. And while the tomatoes are very young, I do like to use the fish fertilizer because it is very high in nitrogen. That gives them a really good boost of growth. So I'm going to go ahead and mix this up. I'm also going to mix some Epsom salt with it. You can mix anything, pretty much anything, with the fish fertilizer. And I'm just going to mix it in a watering can because I don't happen to have a fertilizer attachment on my drip system. So I'm just going to go around and water my plants with my watering can. Might take a little bit of time, but it's better than nothing. So basically, this stuff is highly concentrated. You can pretty much get it at any of your local hardware stores, and it does smell really badly, so get prepared for that. But it's basically just ground up pieces of fish in a liquid form. It's kind of brown, it looks pretty nasty, but I'm gonna pour a couple of capfuls in each watering can. Each watering can full that I mix up and then dilute it with water. So I believe the ratio is about 2 tablespoons for about 2 gallons. It'll tell you on the back of the fish fertilizer. And I just throw in a couple of capfuls. And then for the Epsom salt, this is just a great all-purpose fertilizer. You guys know I love to use this on just about everything in my garden. And I added it to my tomato planting holes about 6 weeks ago when I planted my tomatoes, and now they need an extra boost. So I'm gonna throw about a tablespoon, I'll put about 2 tablespoons in my watering can as well. And this really, really helps the tomatoes to bloom, to blossom. If there's any yellow, it'll clear up the yellowing. And I add this to my tomatoes all season long. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some water to the can here and mix it up. Now we've had a super, super, super hot week this week in triple digits, about 3 days in a row. And I have some tomatoes that just really haven't taken off yet. And I think the heat has kind of gotten to them. So I'm hoping that this will give them the extra boost that they need. Now, my dog actually loves this stuff. If you have cats, they will love this stuff. He always comes running whenever I make a can full. So just be aware of that. The animals will really like it. Okay, it's all mixed up. I just filled it up and stirred it with a stick. Not really anything to it. And the other thing I wanted to mention is this stuff is super inexpensive. The bottle of fish fertilizer I have here is, I believe it's a quart or so, and it was about $7. Just got it at one of the local hardware stores. And this Epsom salt you can pick up anywhere, and it's about maybe about $2.50 or so per bag here. So a super inexpensive way to water or to fertilize your plants. So let's go on over the tomatoes I want to fertilize, and I'll show you how I do it. So now I just want to show you how I water my plants with this concoction that I've made, and also talk a little bit about the frequency. Now these plants here just really haven't taken off that well. We had a little bit of trouble with our watering system here and had to replace some hoses and put in some new drip irrigation. So they haven't gotten as much water as they should have, and you can see they're just not quite as big yet as some of my other plants are. So I want to give them a little bit of a boost, and I'm hoping that this will help. So it's really pretty simple. All you have to do, or all I do, is I just pour this at the base of my plants, trying not to get a lot of the leaves wet, so I try not to water from overhead. Let it sink in, and I just go along my row here and do that to each one of the plants. And just a little bit about frequency. Now the fish fertilizer is good when your plants are young, because like I said, it is really high in nitrogen, gives them that extra boost that they need to get that good leafy green growth. But then as they start growing, I pretty much cut out the fish fertilizer and just use the Epsom salt. So maybe when they're first planted, you know, I don't have a real scientific method to it, but I'd say every couple of weeks with the fish fertilizer and the Epsom salt. And then after that, I'd say I probably water with Epsom salt every couple of weeks. But like I said, I don't have a real scientific method to it. So sometimes just whenever they look like they're looking a little droopy and yellowish, I'll just throw some of the Epsom salt in my watering can and go along and water my plants. So it really does seem to help the tomatoes once they flower to help them set fruit and just be really good producers for me. So I've used this method for many years. Really seems to work. I've always had a huge, huge crop. So I know there's lots and lots of different ways that people like to fertilize their tomatoes. This is just how I like to do it. It's quick, it's simple, it's easy. Anybody can do it. The ingredients are super, super inexpensive, and it just works for me. But if you have a different way that you've tried that works for you, please let us know. Please share. It's a great place to comment down below, and we can all really learn from each other. So I really appreciate you watching. Thank you so much for stopping by. I really love to read all of your comments and respond to them and get a lot of good conversation going here. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope your garden is doing really, really well. Hope it's getting warm where you are, and we'll see you next time.